Hey, this is Sean Overton with OneStepRemove.com. In this video, we're going to go through the basics of working with MetaTrader and show you how to get familiar with the windows that you see. When you first sign up and install the software, you'll have a view that looks very similar to this. And we're going to go through these different windows, show you what they are telling you, and give you the basis for how to manipulate and get comfortable working with the software. In the top left corner, you'll see the Market Watch window. This shows you the live streaming prices from your broker. An example is the dollar against the Swiss franc. Right now it's trading at 111.88 by 111.91. So if you want to sell it, the price is 88. You want to buy it, the price is 91. And you see that all the currency pairs offered are in this window. Down below it, you have the Navigator. This is a list of all the different files that you can use to work with the charts. Most of these are a little more advanced. The more common feature is indicators. So let's say I've got my Euro US dollar 1 hour chart up and I want to apply a second moving average. What I can do is left click on the plus sign next to indicators, scroll down until I find the name, which is moving average. So all I have to do is left click, drag and drop it, and put it on my chart. When I let go, it gives me the option to control the inputs. So instead of studying a 14 period moving average, maybe I want to study a 21 period exponential moving average applied to the close. I don't like crimson, maybe I like steel blue. I push OK and the new indicator pops onto the chart, so now I can study the market. Now as I move the mouse across the screen, you'll see the data window here and how the prices keep changing. So it gives you a summary not only of the time and the price action, but it also tells you what the indicator values are. So if you are having trouble figuring out what they are on the screen, this is much easier on your eyes and it's a lot quicker as well. So let's say you studied the market and you've come to a decision and you decide to trade. So right here I'm looking at Euro US dollar and it's in a clearly defined downtrend. My goal is to enter at market. I'll put my stop up here and we'll see if we can't catch some more moves. What I do is I go back to Market Watch and I left click on the sell price or the bid. You'll see the order window pop up and of course it has the currency pair I selected, and the only thing that's really complicated is volume. If you're used to dealing with other brokers, one standard lot equals one. If you want to do one mini lot or 10,000 units, then it's 0.1. So in this case, we're going to sell one mini lot of Euro US dollar. And we're to push the order through, just push sell. The order went through. Now we're in the market short at 131.82. Push OK, that window closes. And now I realize that, oops, I forgot to put in my stop loss. I want to put it somewhere over this line, so I'll put it at 132.45. The way I do it is I right click on the order and choose modify orders. So I can change the stop loss here, 132.40, push modify, push OK, and now it's done. And you'll see that it's updated here. The account history of the terminal is your closed trades. News is some brokers offer news. Personally, I like to use websites like informtrades.com or marketwatch.com. I find it's a better summary and usually more relevant, but some people like receiving the information in the platform. And the rest of this is mainly oriented towards alerts or logs or problems that occur, and this just keeps files. That's a little more advanced and you really need to know in the beginning. And the remaining topic is how to open new charts, and that's the easiest. You go to File, New Chart, and then your currency pairs are listed here. So let's say I'm interested in dollar yen. It automatically opens a 1 hour chart, so now I want to choose the time frame. All I have to do is either go to Charts, Periodicity, and then I can choose whatever I want, so 5 minute. Let's say I change my mind. This is an easier way to do it, so now I can change it to a 30 minute, 15 minute, etc. If you have any questions, visit our website. It's www.onestepremove.com, or you can shoot us an email at info@onestepremove.com. And again, this is Sean Overton. Thank you for listening.